Welcome back. This is a continuation of the integrated and classic extracts and replicates tuning part. Okay, so I'm going through some parameters over here for integrated replicate, which is parallelism, max parallelism, parallelism interval, parallelism, only parallelism and max parallelism, right? So these three main parameters for the integrated. So now we all know that the applier, so replicate is integrated replicate is divided into four internal components, right? And the last one is apply process, which will directly apply to the target database. So now I can have multiple applier with the parameter parallelism. Okay, so by default the value is 4. Even if I don't specify it, still the value is 4. So that means the minimum number of processes that would be started with the integrated replicate would be 4 by default, and it can go up to max is 30, so it'll go up to 30. Okay, so auto tuning parallelism interval, it enables the auto tuning. So what happens is after 5 seconds, it will check whether it needs more parallel processes or not, whether it needs more applier processes or not. It will increase it, okay, up to 30. So I can change it, right? So after 5 minutes, it will go in and check whether it needs to increase or decrease as well, but it will not decrease below 4 if it is not set by default 4, and maximum by 30. If you want to set, you can set it 2 or 15, something like this, right? Maybe 30 is too much. You want that it is taking so much memory in the database, because anyways, number of processes, number of threads, more memory from the RAM itself, right? So it's going up to 30, you're seeing that it is too much and might take more memory. So you reduce it to 15. So it will not go beyond 15 anytime, or maybe 10, whatever you want. Okay. If you put parallelism is equal to max parallelism, then always it will remain the same. It will disable the auto tuning. So whatever is there in the beginning, you set parallelism to max parallelism, you put 5 and 5. That means initially it will start, 5 processes are started, and at the end only it would be 5 only, right? So there would not be any auto tuning kind of thing over here, right? So then parallelism to 1. If you set parallelism as 1, that means yes, there is no parallelism, okay? No parallelism and no auto tuning. It will behave a single apply process, it will work, but definitely this is not good, and we using integrator for parallelism mainly, right? So it depends, right? It depends if you have some thing like VLOB, CLOB, where you want it should work as in a serial order, you don't need a parallelism, then you can go with parallelism one as well. So these are the major parameters for you can use parallelism, max parallelism. So by default are also good enough. Okay, you can reduce max parallelism. By default, it's also good enough for it to work. So we have further parameters on the SGA side. We have max SGA size. So max SGA size is also a very important parameter. It defines the size it is taking in the SGA within the stream pool. So stream pool, configuring stream pool on the source side is very important. If you're not configuring stream pool, it'll take the memory from the shared pool, which definitely you will not, don't want. So default it is 1 GB for extract. So if you don't specify, it becomes 1 GB. So 1 GB is also good enough for quite a number. You can assume 450,000 to 60,000 statements per minute. This 1 GB is good enough. Okay, maybe up to 90,000 as well, it is good enough, this 1 GB. But if it is less, okay, so you don't set default size, you can reduce it, so that takes less memory from the stream pool and definitely lesser burden on the database overall. But how to identify it, there are different dictionary views we'll discuss later in this chapter. There are different dictionary views where we can check how much is the free memory in the stream pool and how much is actually utilized by the log mining server. Similarly, parallelism is there for the capture as well. So by default it is 2, by default for replicate is 4. So you can increase or decrease as per your requirement. Commit serialization, this is definitely you will don't want to change it, because commit serialization is something which is when it is applying the transaction in async mode. Async mode means that multiple transaction will be applied with multiple applier processes and in an async mode, definitely checking on the dependent transactions. So dependent transaction is the default value, and full mode, if I set it to full mode, then transaction will not be applied in the async mode, it will apply in the sync mode only. Okay, in the same, in this way, I think in the full mode, parallelism will not be benefited, right? It is always applying in one order, so parallelism will not be much needed in that way. Eager size. Eager size is also a very important parameter. Eager size default is good enough, but if case you are feeling a slowness, you have sufficient memory in the RAM, you can increase the value. So in eager size is the size of the buffer or the threshold of the size of the transaction or the number of LCRs. What does it mean is I have number of LCRs is 1000, 10,000. So it sets a size of 9500. For 9500, it will keep on accumulating in the buffer. If it increases by 9500, it will push to the database to write to the database. So 94, it will keep on accumulating and then it will push to the database before a commit is achieved. If a commit is achieved, definitely it will go and push to the database. Okay, so minimum threshold is 95. So sets a threshold for the size of the transaction, after which GoldenGate will start applying the data before a commit record is received. Okay. So the default is 9500. So nothing related to it is much different than your group trans operation and max trans operation. That is related to your commits, right? When a commit will occur, it is not related to a commit is occurring. It will set that it is accumulating that much of statements in the memory before it applies to the transaction. So you need to differentiate on this. You have to see the performance, how you're looking for, but 9500 general cases is an optimum value. But now in the later versions, I think in 18C, 19C, it has been increased as well. Okay, now this 9500 has been increased, okay, to I think 11,000 something, okay, 9,000, 12,000 something, okay. Now is the range. Okay, so range is a parameter. Now you have a lot of option in integrated to have parallelism, but in the classic, what you do, you deploy multiple replicates. You deploy multiple replicates if you want a parallelism. You can divide on the basis of tables and schemas, but what if a table is very big, just like 2 TB, 1 TB, or such tables? So multiple, I cannot divide the table like that, right? So what happens? This range function will help me to divide the table. In case of integrated, in case of same table also, it will divide. It will have multiple parallel threads for the same table also. But in case of classic, there is no option. So what will happen is classic, you can use a range. So now you can see this example over here. Now this is replicate 1, 2, and 3. Now I am dividing into 3. So range 1, 3. So this is the first thread. This is the second thread. This is the third thread, right? Second, 2, 3, 3, 3. So it is dividing single table into 3 replicates. So divides workload into multiple randomly distributed groups of data. Guarantees the same row will always be processed by the same process. Determines which group that range falls in by computing a hash against the primary key. So always, once the row is inserted by replicate 1, if a update comes for that row, it will always process by the same replicate only. Similarly, second and third as well. Okay. So I think this is very clear. Okay, you are dividing a single table into multiple replicates only in case of classic. Integrated not required. Next, the TCP stats for the pump. So what pump is doing? Pump is sending the data to the target through the network. So what all you need to check on, you have to check on the buffer size, flash bytes. So all this you can set. So buffer size and flash bytes. So these parameters can be set, can be resized in case you put these parameters in the parameter file of pump. Okay. So you can see, I can view this parameter with send extract. And the name of the process, get TCP stats. Here you can get the buffer size. Here you can get the flush size. So now size of the buffer and the size, the minimum size where it is flushing. Okay. So now if you want to improve the performance, you can change the parameter. But your network bandwidth should be good enough if you want to increase it. Okay. So these are the couple of parameters you can change on the pump side. So you can change on the pump side this couple of parameters, buffer size and the size of the buffer. So TCP flush bytes. Okay. This is the thing where we can tune pump. So nothing much where we can tune pump. So these couple of parameters only for tuning the pump. Next is the startup speed. Okay. So when you're starting your process, what happens is By default, what happens is when you start in the process, you use these wildcards. You say Scott dot star. Scott is the name of the schema. Any schema name, maybe HR dot star. So what does it does it? It will internally expand the wildcard to create a list of the included tables. Okay, it will create a list of the table, and in case of target also, in case of replicate as well, it will keep on checking whether when you are resolving the tables, when you are mapping the tables, they are correct or not. So it will include the list of included tables. It will verify the tables exist on the database or not, if you have included just like Scott.emp kind of. So it will keep on, it will check while starting. Okay, but while starting, I assume there is no use, right? While starting, there is no use. If you're using a star and asterisk, there are 500, 600 tables. So startup speed will be slowed down. Okay. Why not check only when the transaction comes in for that particular table? Yes, we can check that as well. So by default, it will check immediately during the startup, but you can set it to dynamic. So dynamic option, what to do? Dynamic option will resolve it only when the transaction for that particular tables comes in. Okay, so you can use a dynamic parameter in your parameter file. You can say wildcard resolve dynamic to check only when the transaction comes in the table for that table. Otherwise, it will use Scott.star. It will go to the database, find the list of tables in the Scott schema, just create a list of the included schema. And in the target, it will start mapping it as well when starting. So startup suite will slow down. But if you don't worry about the startup suite, you can may not use this parameter as well. Okay, so it's only for your startup speed of your process. Okay, so that ends this parameters thing, which we can do playing with the parameters for the GoldenGate, extract, pump and replicate. In the next section, we will discuss about the dictionary views and whether different health check reports where we can gather and monitor our GoldenGate in a better way. Okay, see you in the next section.